Hey everybody, Josh the RV Nerd here at Bish's RV on a beautiful day, taking a look at some updates on the 2445 Rockwood, previously Rockwood Ultra Series, now Rockwood Signature. Major thing here, Rockwood has made all of their fifth wheels part of their Signature Series floor plans. There is just no more middle child, effectively, so Jan lost to Marsha. What we're looking at here, though, this is one of the very best traveling fifth wheels I could even imagine out there. The entire thing is, it's less than 29 feet, not even less than 30, it's better than that. It also rides on Goodyear tires with factory tire pressure monitoring, and also has torsion axles and suspension, which for going down highways and stuff like that is one of the best systems that you're gonna be able to find out there. Additionally, no slides on the door side with a maximized patio space really lets you enjoy your campsite, and the traveling access on this one, you can use the bed, the bathroom, the kitchen, all when the slide is closed. Nothing is really blocked off and locked off. It's fantastic in that regard. These are now for 23 double Asdell walls, so Asdell layering inside and out. They've standardized bigger air conditioners. We're looking at RV Today with optional second air. You can do things like add extra solar to this. They have a factory standard 1,000-watt inverter, which isn't massive, but it's 1,000 watts more than most brands have, and that little outdoor mini fridge. Even that can be active when you're going down the road, which most outdoor refrigerators are not. It's got tank heaters and bigger vent fans, better ceiling vent covers, roof vent covers, all kinds of things. It's got a couple little weird points too. We're gonna hit the good and the weird both along the way. Let me know what you like and dislike. And if you appreciate showing you the good and the weird, hit that, so stupid, hit the subscribe button. Let's go. And this video is another good example of the fact that you can get these more than one way. Like if you look at the history of this channel, you've seen that I've recorded this RV several times in previous seasons, but almost always with like a lighter, brighter interior decor color. You can get it here in the HOA approved brown. I'll also say, this is not my personal preference, but that's the thing. I don't have to like it. You do. And if you don't like it, we'll get you one with the lighter decor. Now, you've got a choice between a table and chairs and the booth dinette that you see over here. But Rockwood does a really good booth dinette. First of all, since it's load-bearing, anything they build in-house has an all-aluminum welded skeleton. Not to mention that free-floating table you can pull over in front of the sofa next to where I'm standing. That's now carpetless. They got, well, actually last year they were carpetless now that I think about it. And like I said, we got the sofa right over here next to us, staring across at Boardwalk and Park Place with the entertainment package. Now, that is not the world's biggest TV, obviously. They only had limited diagonal room that they could shove something in there. But the thing is, the whole flipping thing is just nothing but storage. Like the entire L-shaped kitchen chunk of this thing is just nothing but storage space. It's fantastic. That's also a bigger oven. That is a larger 22-inch oven versus the common 16s. You may notice solid surface countertops all the way around in here. Gigantic microwave in this sucker too. It's not convection. Sometimes when you see big microwave and like luxury fifth wheels, you become kind of accustomed to convection. It's not what that is. Up top here, you can add on things like extra max air vent fans. And when you get the bigger fans, first of all, this is all they use. They don't use the smaller 4-inch fart fans. They only use the Fajita Friday Fume Fighters. The other thing, when you get it, you also automatically get the roof vent cover to go with it. 12-volt fridge has become the standard. RV has 200 watts of solar standard. You can get a gas electric two-way fridge. It will be an 8 cubic foot on this specific floor plan, mind you. Now, this is one of those things someone's going to go, oh, I love that, or boy, that sucks. I don't know which one it's going to be, but they had just kind of a funky monkey pocket back here. And a lot of people said, man, I'd put like an air fryer, I'd put a coffee maker. You know, I'd be kind of curious, what would you do back in that corner? Because the appliances really seem to be the general default answer, especially with that pop-up power tower back there. Now, while you're kind of leaving me a little comment, I'm going to crack open all the different storage facilities here and let you know all the different spaces this has. Now that this is a Signature Series and not their Ultra Series, it has soft close residential drawers. And they do that all the way through. They also do that up in the bedroom. And the upper kitchen corner cabinet, it was just like a dead weird pocket of space. You couldn't do anything with it. Now they have that like little slide open elevated mini pantry. I love that. That'd be just a sweet little spice rack if you're a kitchen cook-em-up kind of person. Now, again, the prep space in this one is a little bit limited. I think you could leverage that free-floating dinette table, assuming you get the booth variety, to act as a little bit of extra counter space if you need it. Not to mention, the RV has like a little mini-ish camp kitchenette on the outside, so you can kind of leverage your inside and outside space depending on how it's all kind of put together. Now, the RV has day-night roller shades, being a new member of the Signature Series. That's one of the other little upgrades and benefits. So it's kind of funny. The RV has a bunch of upgrades, but it also, in a sense, doesn't, because these are just normal things for the Signature Series. But this RV was not built in the Signature Series last year. It was built in the Ultra Series. And if you don't know what that means, basically, instead of the mid-trim package, it's now built only exclusively at the upper trim package. This right here, you may have noticed, is the trifold sleeper sofa. Like, the version of this we're looking at today is the Max Sleeper. I think, personally, I'd go for a theater right there straight across from the entertainment center, but that's my two cents. Now, if you look around this thing, keep an eye out for the little white lettering on those power outlets. It says inverter circuit. This RV has the 1,000-watt inverter on it straight from the factory. It means that that outlet can be live exclusively off battery power. Not to mention, if you look up at that little bottom cubby in this storage cabinet above the sofa, there's actually a set of USB plugs in there. So you do have a cool little phone charge station, which is kind of nice. Now, another nice thing, like, it's obvious that the thing has some great windows over on the poop side off the dinette. But when you actually sit down, you got a full window in the door. You got the windows over here in the kitchen. You actually don't have bad campsite window coverage. So it's got kind of a little, you know, double edge attack going on right there. Now, moving upstairs, there's also some nice little details the Signatures have always put in. Like the little magnet hold back on the bathroom door. Montana does that kind of stuff. It works fantastically. This also has what I like to call welcome back Cotter lighting, because you whoop and it goes, oh, hey, what's up, man? You know, and it just kicks itself on when you need it. Now, that big vent fan in the kitchen that you can't reach, you don't need to. It's got a remote control. You've got another one of those, by the way, up here in the bathroom space. So I'm at kind of a funky, let me give you a better look at that. And while I'm doing that, give you a better look at that linen cabinet over here next to the toilet. Notice the nice detail work, how it's not just like open face so that all your stuff in there falls down when you get to your destination. Now, last year, remember how this had a swinging door and everybody said it annoyed them? Well, they rearranged some things and now we've got the pocket door that everybody wanted. Nice. Porcelain foot flush. You can see some good leg room around that thing. And that remote control can be used to activate that fan, depending on, well, the result. I'll just leave it at that. And that's already probably a little too bit. Basically, they redesigned this bathroom a little bit is kind of what I'm getting at here. This is, I think, one of the other nicer updates and upgrades on this one. What they didn't do, they did not get rid of the awesome headroom over there in that shower. That is one of the things for a smaller fifth wheel. They're doing a very, very good job there. And I like how they mount that shower head way, way up high. Now, if I actually get here in the shower, climbing in the shower with me sounds a little bit creepy pasta, but hey, here we are. You've got the handy shower miser system over there. So if you are boondocking, you can make sure that you're not wasting any of the fresh water out of your holding tank waiting for the water to get warm. Also, look at the little details, like the fact that both sides of the shower have the shower door holdbacks. It's just dumb, stupid, little, smart, easy details like that. That's where Rockwood wins for me, just time after time after time. Now, the bedroom TV up here looks kind of funky right now. You'll see that it does pivot. It's an optional TV. You also see that there wasn't a whole lot of other place for them to necessarily put it. These are 50 amp. You can always add the second air, but we've done so from the factory right here. And that's a low profile air. What that means is basically it's not going to screw up your total exterior height. Now, looking down here, this is a 60 by 80 true queen. It's not a shorty. There's also no allowance from the factory for a king bed. So you're going to want to kind of keep that in mind. The thing is, though, with that bedroom closet slide closing, that's just kind of the way that they decided to go. And they have to really standardize things very heavily based on their, welded cage aluminum construction. The headboard side outlets, they're both wired to that inverter. So like if you got a little wireless phone charge pad that doesn't necessarily operate off USB, you can do that over there. And it's only a single bedroom window, but with all that being mirrored, it does look and feel a little bit bigger over here. You know when that slide closes, they maybe could have gone ahead and put the TV space up here, but I think they also didn't want to block your walkthrough kind of space. They didn't clip it with your shoulder or anything goofy like that. It's also probably more sturdy and stable over here on the wall where it's mounted, because they actually have a mounting plate for it. Looking down below, you see that aluminum cage work going on. And where there is a little bit of carpet in this bedroom, it's really not a walkable space. The closet slide over on the side has dresser storage. There's dresser storage also beside it as well. And I was actually a little surprised when I saw that the overhead cabin doors in Rockwoods, I think they've just gotten rid of the struts across the family. That shocks me. All the amazing extra detail work they're doing, and that's where they decided to pull the pin. It just kind of, I don't know, I didn't see that coming. And now slide closed, time for road mode here. Like I was saying, this bed setup, one of the benefits of it, there's zero question. The fact is you can definitely use that in transit. When a bed is in a slide, frankly, nobody can really tell you because there's no authority that actually tests for slide closed access and function rather. In towable RVs, obviously I'm over here checking slide closed access. And that's one of the things, like that goofy refrigerator positioning. This is the reason they do that. Because like the bed slide sister to this floor plan, when the slide closes, you lose the refrigerator in that one. In this one, you definitely do not. All that prep space, all the, you know, your sink, the majority of your storage. And obviously you got all the pantrytainment storage is lost, but you can get to the fridge, no question. You want to make sure, though, a little pro tip for you from your Uncle Josh, make sure you put that table down when you travel. I kind of simulated this here. Imagine if this thing was bucking and chucking down the road. It would jiggle bang all over the place. Your tabletop would probably either break and or get gouged by things like your fire escape window little lever job thing there, technical term, obviously. You get the idea. So if you appreciate the little tips like that, showing you the road mode, if you're new with us, hit subscribe. If you've returned, first of all, welcome back, Nerd Herd. Secondly, like that video, let's roll. Now, once again, this thing tipped a tail just shy of 29 feet. And I watch the comment section. Like, get the popcorn ready and watch the comment section. Like clockwork, I'm going to get the question, is this half-ton towable? Despite the fact that I'm answering it right here in the video. I just suspect some people don't need to listen to me blather on that long. Anyway, what I'm getting at here is, I don't really think so. I don't know if I necessarily still, even a small fifth wheel like this still gives me concern when it comes to pairing up with a half ton for the same reason it always does. Half tons usually don't have the payload rating to properly handle a fifth wheel with this much hitch weight. It's not the dry weight, it's not the length. It's the hitch weight that becomes the deal-breaking factor right there. These do come with a curt turning point hitch, by the way, which if you decide you can, basically you can flip it over into pivot mode. So if you've got like a really short bed pickup, you can help the RV shift away from the bed of the truck a little bit, although you're now creating an extra pivot point for backing the RV up. Can be a little bit tricky, but it's also better than smashing up the back window of your pickup. Looking at a couple optional things today, like the white and graphite monotone exterior here, the IBM monotone, as well as the slide awnings. You can always put those on later, but you can also get them right from the factory. And they offer them so cheap compared to what you could get aftermarket at a dealership. Sometimes certain things are that way and some things absolutely are not. Got those Goodyear Endurance radials down here with that torsion axle and suspension system. Like if you peek in between them, what you see is nothing, because it's not a leaf spring system. The idea here that basically this works the opposite of leaf springs without getting too technical. And what that's essentially going to do is this thing's going to try to ride and handle like it's on rails going down the road, you know. One thing that is kind of a, is the fact that you do have dual sewer outlets on this one. You've got one in front of the tires for the bathroom, one behind the tires for the rear kitchen. Kind of a bummer. It is what it is. Now, somebody asked me the other day, is this the fuel inlet for the onboard generator? No, don't put gasoline in that. That is a fresh water tank. you've got a good pass-through on this too. You see how you've got that kind of enclosed docking center. Now that little coily hose with the sprayer handle on it, you can use that over by the, it's not a camp kitchen, but the little cooker station. And on the left, that's our 1,000-watt inverter, which is keeping that outside fridge and a bunch of the outlets able to be functional
in transit. And if I do get right down here next to the automatic leveling system that is now standard on these, you see the enclosed belly. What you don't see is the radiant barrier, and what you don't see are the 12-volt holding tank heating pads that they've had on these for longer than, like, Rockwood's been doing this before it was cool, or Flagstaff. What's a Flagstaff called? A 524EWS? I think I'm trying to learn my Flagstaff numbers, but I've handled Rockwood personally for so many years, I just speak Rockwood. Anyway, working our way around, as I mentioned previously, these are all signatures now. Rockwood just only makes one level of fifth wheel at this stage, but when they did that, they also included double ASDO in the walls that was just not there before. So Rockwood is really slow to work ASDO up through their lineup, and evidently they've seen good enough records, they've figured out how to laminate it so that it doesn't peel, because that's the thing, people go, why doesn't everyone just use ASDO? Well, there's benefits to it, there's also drawbacks to it, but ASDO laminates differently. And it's not just use ASDEL instead of wood. It's a tricky process. It changes how manufacturers laminate. And in the last couple years, not a lot of brands have had the free time to do some experimentation back in the development plant. Notice this is all carpetless. So if you got wet stuff, you're packing up in the morning. This is not gonna turn into an organic mildew factory or anything like that in here. Also, they put about the biggest patio awning on this thing they could. And certainly it's not the biggest I've ever seen, but for a small fifth wheel, that coverage is excellent. And look at the entry door, dead center in the middle of that thing. Now that means that the steps eat up a chunk of the awning space, sure. But it also means on a rainy day, you can slip in and out and not get spritzed in the face, which is nice. Again, some pretty decent campsite window coverage. And I mean, maybe we don't call it a true camp kitchen, but what you do have over here is that higher pressure cold water sprayer port with hot and cold, which is nice. You've also got a factory supplied griddle. And of course there's a propane cooker hooker right down below that. A little handy work shelf and that little outdoor fridge. So it's got a cooker, it's got some table space, it's got a water source, it's got a fridge. Those are all the basic bare necessities of an outside camp kitchen. And I just stepped into I don't know what kind of disgusting muck that is now in my not waterproof shoes. And I backed directly into a ladder when the camera lurched. That felt good in the center of the back. Anyway, the cargo rack on the back here. So first of all, look down below. These always have a bumper and a receiver hitch, not towing, but receiver hitch. The only difference, by the way, they're the physically same hitch. They have the exact same weight capacities. It just doesn't have safety chain hooks and a four-way wiring harness. Other than that, they're physically identical. But the cargo rack on the back, that can fold down to, I think theirs is about, what is that, 250 pound rating. And of course, they're still giving us a ladder to get up to that walkable roof so we can do things like, well, record it. Duck! Anyway, like my underwear, I'm gonna make this brief, or at least I'm gonna try. Up top here, you might notice when you add the front air conditioner, they do a low profile. So when you look at the exterior height measurements on this, you don't have to wonder, is that with or without the air conditioner? It's always with or without. It doesn't matter. It's Schrodinger's height measurement. Look how clean this is. Look at the workmanship. Look how just cleanly, like, look at the pride they take in just the seals. That's just awesome. It's awesome. Now, where you get the bigger vent fans, you always get the bigger max air vent covers. And again, today we're looking at the standard factory 200 watt solar. Factory can option on a second panel. I think you can option on a third one. And this year they're using 200 watt panels instead of 190, so you can really maximize your input. Now, there's other things I think that you might want to see and compare. Like if you're like, okay, you know what? You had me until I saw the bedroom. I need an east-west bedside. I need a bigger closet. No sweat. I've got a video for that. It's called a 2442 Rockwood. If you want to see something else this size that has good traveling access, take a look at the 23MLE Cougar. Basically, take a look at the video description. I've got all kinds of information there for you, including links to some of these other things that I'm rattling off, because I don't expect you to remember the alphabet soup the way I do. I don't know what you do for a living, but I better know jack and squat about it, and if you rattled off a bunch of stuff, I bet I wouldn't remember it. So it's all listed right there when you're ready. And when you're ready, give us a call. We'll get you camping, man. No hidden fees, no nonsense, just straight deals. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone. Thank you.